Hey guys, it's Di, and I wanted to share my skincare routine with you guys today. I have been watching a number of videos on Diamond and Heels 14 channel, and I will go ahead and link it down below if you guys haven't seen it before. And I just recently found her channel. I think she's been around for quite some time, so you guys have probably already come across her. But I was inspired by watching kind of her acne story and that sort of thing to share my current skincare routine with you guys, and then possibly even in a different video, maybe kind of share more of a background story. So I am 29 years old now, so I'm kind of in a different age category than she is in, but when I was more closer to her in age, around the time of like 16 to 17 till around 18 to 19, so a few years in there, I did have slight acne to moderate acne pretty much like on my chin area. And so I went to the dermatologist a lot during that time period, and I tried a lot of different things, and then eventually I kind of fell into, I think, something that really worked for me and did some things that worked for me. And so now at 29 years old, and then pretty much for the majority of my 20s, luckily it's just pretty much sporadic, one time a month, you know, little tiny places, and not like this continual kind of thing that I was dealing with when I was a teenager. And obviously if you are a teenager and you're watching this, I mean, it will get better, hopefully. You just have to be diligent about your skincare and find the routine that works for you. So I thought also if I share my story in the future, maybe it'll kind of give you hope, because obviously my face is cleared up quite a bit. So there is like light at the end of the tunnel. It can get better. So let me go ahead and share my current routine. Again, I'm 29 years old, so what works for me may not work for an older person or younger person, but I do have quite the arsenal of, of skincare products here next to me, so I'll try to go through them as quickly as possible. And the ones I go through first will be the ones that I use the most often, so like every day. And then the first thing I will say is throughout all those years when I was like going to the dermatologist constantly, you know, they would ask you, you know, are you cleansing? Yes. Are you doing this? Yes. Are you toning and exfoliating? All these different things. No one said to me, I mean, I realized at the time I should take my makeup off at night and like wash my face, but no one ever said to me, hey, you should be cleansing, using toner and moisturizer at night also. I didn't find that out until recently, and that has made a huge difference in my skin. Even after I haven't had to deal with acne and that sort of thing, my skin has looked more refreshed since I started cleansing, toning, and moisturizing at night. I know that sounds silly, and probably everyone knew this in the world except for me, but I didn't know that you were supposed to tone and moisturize at night in addition to doing it in the morning. So anyways, what I do, I use a different cleanser in the shower, and unfortunately I don't have it here to show you because I just ran out of it and I'm waiting for the new one to come, and it's back ordered with Amazon because it's coming with one of my daughter's DVDs that gets released on Tuesday. But anyways, it's the CBU Beauty Cleanser, and I actually got it to try as a part of a review back in like March, and I loved it. I've been using it constantly since then, and I've actually replenished it, so this will be a replenishment that I'm receiving that I bought on my own. And it works really nicely on my skin. It has just a little bit of exfoliation beads in it that are very gentle, and I love the way that it smells. So there's a separate review on that if you would like to see that, but that is the cleanser that I use in the shower. And then also morning and night, I use this Mario Badescu Skincare Line Special Cucumber Lotion, and this is what I use as a toner. So after I get out of the shower, I use this to tone my face, and I use this with these little cotton pads that I get at Target. And then I use a different moisturizer in the morning than I do at night. And the moisturizing lotion that I use at night is the Up and Up version of the Aveeno Radiant Skin Moisturizer. And I like the texture of the Aveeno one better. So this is what I've been using for a really long time, and I really like that as well. And then at night, I use a different cleanser. This is the Up and Up version. It's kind of like the Cetaphil cleanser, which I've used Cetaphil, you know, way back then. Of course, all dermatologists tell you to use that. So use this at night because it's supposed to be really gentle. And then I do a routine of cleansing, toning with my Mario Badescu Special Cucumber Lotion. And then at night, I use a special dual treatment moisturizer that is, it's got salicylic acid in it. Just even though I don't really, you know, have to battle acne now, I just kind of like getting things like this to kind of help you know, maybe ward off or not have problems in the future. So use this at night, and it's a great moisturizer that also kind of helps prevent any breakouts. And this is also the Up and Up version of this. It's called Dual Treatment Moisturizer, compared to Clean and Clear Dual Action Moisturizer. So I like this at night for whatever reason. So that is my daily routine, and so I do similar things in the morning and at night, but I use slightly different products. And then once a week or so, I will use this Mario Bedicchio Strawberry Face Scrub, and this is an exfoliator that's just really cool. It's like a pink, like kind of, not really a gel, but it's kind of a thicker consistency, and it's got little strawberry seeds in it, so it feels really neat on your face. And I use that on my face, and then also exfoliate my arms with this like once a week. So those are the things that I use most regularly, and then I have a number of like spot treatments and that sort of thing that I use if I need them at the time. Oh, well, the last thing that I use fairly regularly, if I can remember to use it, is Mario Bedicchio Hyaluronic Eye Cream. And this is the eye cream I've been using for a few years now, but I'm actually in the search right now to find a different eye cream that's maybe just a little bit more moisturizing, because I feel like going into my 30s, I need something that's a little bit more heavy duty. So I like this. This worked well when I was like in my 20s, but I feel like it's maybe not quite as good for my 30s, when that's going to be more of an issue. So the rest of the things are all spot treatments, or I use just only if I need to. And this is an oil-free makeup remover, just a side note from Neutrogena. This stuff works really well to remove your eye makeup if you've got a lot of heavy eye makeup on. And then I also sometimes use this Rare Minerals Facial Burst Moisturizer if I want some extra moisture, especially like in the summer. I'll put this on after my moisturizer that I use during the day before I do my makeup. And then some really cool spot treatments from Mario Bedicchio, which is one of my favorite skincare brands. I've just found that it works really well with my skin and has improved the texture and tone of it after I started using a lot of their products. If I am having like clogged pores and that sort of thing, I found that this Mario Bedicchio Silver Powder in combination with the Biore Nose Cleansing, they're like the little strips that you put on there and then rip it off. I think these are probably really bad for your skin, but I've used these for a long, long time, and they get the job done. So what you do is you put a cotton ball that's just been wetted a little bit, and you dip it down inside of this. I'm going to try not to get this everywhere because it looks like powdered sugar, basically. I don't think you're probably going to be able to see it, but it looks basically like powdered sugar. So you just take a wet cotton ball and you dab it on your face where you're wanting to clear your pores. And you let this sit and dry. And then I use my toner to remove it. And then after that, I go in with the Biore strips and let those sit on my face, let those dry, and then take those off. And when you use those two things combined, it really just pulls all the excess kind of gunk and excess oil that's built up in your pores that you're trying to get out of there. Those two things work really well, in my opinion, together. So that's just something I do very rarely, maybe not even once a month, just when it gets to a point where I feel like I need to do it. The next thing from Mario Bedicchio, which is awesome, like this is like a miracle secret, is the drying lotion. And this is for like whitehead type acne that's, you know, kind of like broken out, and maybe what you would get if it's like once a month type acne. I don't know why this is making me nervous to talk about this. But anyways, so I use a Q-tip, and you use actually the pink sediment that's down here at the bottom. And I use a Q-tip to get the pink sediment out of the bottom. The liquid is just to kind of keep it settled, I guess. And you dab that onto wherever you're needing the spot treatment. And literally, like, overnight, this usually zaps it and takes care of it, like, right away. So I would highly recommend if you have, like, more of a, like, whitehead type of breakout, that this stuff would help it, like, immediately. And then this is the Mario Bedicchio Buffering Lotion, and this is more for like cystic acne, where there's, you know, no real kind of pinpoint that you can find where the problem is, but it's just, you know, more cystic in nature. And actually, when I used to have, you know, more breakouts and that sort of thing when I was younger, it was actually more along the lines of cystic acne and more hormonal. Now that I've gotten older, it's kind of the opposite. But on the very rare occasion that I do you know, maybe get a cystic acne thing, which is honestly not, I'm thinking about it, very rare these days. But anyhow, I have.
So that
this.
Is my skincare routine, and hopefully this has been helpful if you've been looking at any of those individual products. And all of these products, I went through kind of an extensive process to kind of try a lot of different things out and find the things that work the best for me.
So this has kind of been a year or two in the making that I found these products that I really love and work the best for my skin. So feel free to send me comments or questions about any of the specific products if you've been looking at those, and I would be happy to do a review. Like, if you want to know more about like this Mario Badishi brand especially, this is one that I came across. It's at Ulta, and I found a lot of great things from this brand for my skin, and they have a lot of great things that work with different skin types as well. So this is a great one to look into. So thanks so much for watching, and have a great day.